And I'll say that, you know, initially when I joined the business, I joined KBL after I left the startup, after the startup was sold in the US. I joined KBL in 2007. And at that point in time, KBL had somehow metamorphed itself from being more a product company to becoming a project company, because at the time there were a large number of irrigation water supply projects in India. And so we thought, you know, it's a great idea. We make big pumps, so why not make the whole scheme? Seemed like a great idea, and we did some very good schemes, including the Sardar Sarovar scheme in Gujarat. But what happened was, over time, by 2010, we noticed that the government was having serious issues paying contractors. And that caused a real skew in our business, because 75% of our business in India came from projects, and the rest came from products. And when the government stopped paying us, like they did to many other contractors, it put serious cash flow pressures on the business. And I remember that my father had promised himself after 1991 that we would always remain a debt-free company. And we were a debt-free company all the way up to 2009 or 2008. And we saw the debt sort of rising up again in, you know, as the government wasn't paying us and we had to fund working capital. And at the time, you know, we had a few options. You know, we had to, the only real option was growing the product business. But growing the product business by 500 to 1500 crores in a 2 to 3 year span was not very easy. And we had to employ all sorts of new techniques to make that happen. And the first one was, the easiest one would have been to employ a lot of people to increase sales. But the area we chose to look at was invest significantly in artificial intelligence. And we used that as a way to, you know, document and manage knowledge that our salespeople have and that our application engineering team sort of has developed over the years, which is all converted into logic. And this allowed us to cater to large numbers of customers quicker, much quicker, and also without all the overhead costs that it would require if you had huge number of people. Right, so that was the first time we sort of invested a lot of money into AI, which we continue to invest today, but that's when we saw the real impact of AI. And slowly over the years, we've also, of course, changed payment terms, because, you know, payment terms are important when you need cash, and you know, managing cash, managing debt, I think, was really important. But at the same time, managing people and managing, you know, their morale and managing their enthusiasm and their engagement, I think that was really important in India at that time. And that is what really ensured that attrition rates were low, and we were able to resolve issues. We couldn't resolve all the issues immediately, because, you know, when you have big projects with the government, it takes a long time. But at least we were able to make progress without attrition, because people were engaged and motivated and passionate. And that's what finally companies are about, right? They're about people.